in some ways, we're lucky because the source material is only a 100-page novella, so we're not overwhelmed with multiple books that are hundreds of pages each. You know, our first 10 episodes basically follow the template laid out in the 100 pages, which is really, we're lucky.
And if you're going to do that, you're allowed to take liberties because the 100 pages, it's not all in the 100 pages. I think the other thing that was a blessing is that this is a show on a spaceship. So there are some, I'd say, character and thematic comparisons people can make to something like Game of Thrones, but sort of the nuts and bolts of it are very different.
It's so contained.
Yeah, and so that, I think, again, liberating in that we can walk away from some of the expectations of Game of Thrones. You know, some of them will still be there.
Was George involved at all with the
game? Yeah, he was super supportive. You know, he gave feedback on the pilot episode. You know, he's made himself completely available to Jeff. So, you know, he's got his hands full.
Yeah.
So it's not like he had time to come to the writer's room, but he definitely weighed in and gave feedback.
And gave his blessing. I mean, his comment was, you know, it's obviously a little bit different than my book, but I understand why it is, because you're making a TV show out of it. And, you know, I like it a lot. So that was a relief to hear.
He also comes from the TV.
Yeah, yeah. Yes. He loves TV.
Yeah. Yeah. He understands the process for sure.
How gory do we expect it to get with the
horror? It's pretty gory.
It's pretty bloody. Yeah, I think what you saw up there is a good indicator. We tried not to hold back. So nobody ever said we couldn't do something. So we just kept doing it.
No, we've been surprised as we turned in the cuts to sci-fi. We thought, oh, surely they'll ask us to tone some of this down. And haven't asked us to tone anything down.
Wow.
So maybe we aren't going far enough. I don't know. But I thought we were.
So next season, maybe a little more. Actually, just a little bit, not that way, right?
That would, that'd be awesome.
Happy to talk about it next season.
So, other than the source material, what other inspirations did you pull from when you're crafting the show and how it plays out?
Well, I think I heard Jeff talk about some of his sort of, you know, Jeff, our creator, is steeped in the horror world. He's written some adaptations. He finished an adaptation for the new Pet Cemetery. So you'll see splashes of lots of different things, both from the sci-fi world and from the horror world, in this show. But hopefully there's also something really unique at the center of it. Because I think by the time you get to the middle episodes of the first season, it's pretty bananas kind of stuff that I can't say that I've seen before.
We were a good counterbalance to Jeff. Jeff is kind of bananas and insane. If you've ever seen Midnight Meat Train, you know what he likes to write. And we're very grounded and character-driven, so you know, we would always try to root things back in character and make it feel good. Like George's novel said, however many years in the future, we want to pull it back to today and make it feel more relatable by allowing the audience to recognize today's world a little bit more. So we were always finding that balance with Jeff.
But you'll
in
see,
a healthy way.
But like to answer your question, you'll see some shining in here. You'll see some sunshine.
We love sunshine.
You'll see some alien. I mean, the way that Alien depicted sort of life in space, and it's very earthy and grounded at the same time. Gritty. There's a little bit of that in the show. So those are some things.
Based on what I'm seeing from the show, it's not a classic type of feature in terms of the technology. It's a little bit more of the alien feel, correct?
Yeah, more near future. There's no, you know, there are some things that are kind of mind-blowing when you get into
there
it.
Is some futuristic technology, but we tried to craft it in a way that felt like, oh, that could exist in 75 years. We weren't thinking about technology in sort of like a clean slate kind of way. It was sort of like, what can we do today, and what might we be able to do in 75 years? There is some futuristic technology in the show that you can track.
I'll give you a good example. Like when we were designing the spaceship, if you have the time to look at that spaceship, there's parts of the ship that look like it was made now. It looks like we used the International Space Station as a model for the early parts of the ship, and then it grew over time. Most spaceships, you look at their they're, it looks like they're made all at once. And this ship has old parts, and then newer parts, and then really new parts. And you can see the age of the ship as you move down.
Well, because our production designer came in and said, it's like, well, you know, even 75 years in the future, if you were to build a ship of this size, you'd probably have to do it over a period of time. And you probably have to build a chunk of it in space, because the ship this large couldn't escape its gravity. So we're like, oh, well, that leads us in some interesting directions. Let's just run with that and play the reality.
And that becomes part of the storytelling. There's older parts of the ship that people haven't been to. And we'll see in the series, and that reveals something important.
For the character, did you kind of create parts for each of the characters?
Yeah, I mean, we needed to create, you know, the novella gets to the heart of the matter. They're on a trip and some things go wrong, and then they sort of get where they were going. Characters need a more of an arc. So, again, we took inspiration from what was there, but then we just added to it.
Did you follow through, like, a set? Principle saying, okay, these are five things you're going to put the five are going to see, and that's when you kind of went back to every time you kind of started designing or thinking about other ways of taking the series in your creative directions?
There was different things at different times. I'd say that when we first started writing the season, it seemed like, yeah, there was a short list of these are the things that are absolutely like benchmarks for the show. And then there were a couple times where like episodes weren't quite coming together, and Jeff and I both went back and reread the novella and found new inspiration to solve some of the problems that we were having in the novella. So it happened a little bit. Yes, we had some big ideas, and we also went back to it.
Well, we're not writing. But I don't know. I mean, my personal favorite, I love Angus's character. He's the most fun in the show. But, you know, there's the Thale character, who you really haven't seen yet, is also those are the two most exciting characters.
So Thale, to real people in 75 years in the future, we acknowledge that psychics are roughly scientific thing. There's a little bit of a mythology for it in the show, and our main character, Carl DeBrandon, chooses to bring a powerful psychic on this mission to try to talk to the aliens when he gets there, and that's part of where some of the wrinkles come from on the journey.